idiot! Each time you take a look at the Russian black metal band that not only plays black metal, but also blends in a little bit of heavy metal and lots of progressive elements. Welcome! This is Dagor Bragolak. And the debut album is called Cosmogony of Yggdrasil. Whew! Such a hard pronounced words, which I cannot probably pronounce. Anyway, here you have the debut album released by KLS Records. This is actually already a 2020 release by this Russian band, and it came here a little bit late, but nevertheless, here we are, a fine looking digipack once again. And this one is a curious case. Now, first of all, what makes this rather curious is that, considering that this is the debut album of the band, and considering that this is not a veteran project of sorts, everything here sounds so experienced. Everything here really resonates with a lot of, well, experience and also the kind of a veteran thing. That is, very, very well produced album that sounds powerful, crisp, clear, yet not sounding sterile. That is, you know, even those bass guitars, which are so often on the background when we're talking about black metal especially, they have their space, they have the room for all these music, all the instruments. So instead of going to this very lo-fi, sometimes very raw and primitive, and sometimes just weak and powerless sound of black metal music, here with Dagor Bragolak, you have all the kind of all the elements. It's like the opposite of raw black metal, not only in terms of production and sound, but also when it comes to songwriting. And that's what makes this interesting. So I think when this band is labeled such as melodic black metal, I think it's a little bit misleading. However, it has a point as well, because the music here is in fact rather melodic. Now, this band has been here since 2016, so not very old, and only a couple of smaller releases before this full-length album. But these guys sound so not only experienced, but talented. You know, they really know what they're doing, except for a couple of things maybe. But before that, let's get into the whole deal here. Now, this one is made of 11 tracks, of which the last one is a cover song. And not any kind of cover song, but almost running for 11 minutes. Which is kind of too much, considering that the band's own material is clearly not that lengthy. You know, making this album 66 minutes long, that is what my CD player anyway was ticking, whereas this is a little bit less. It's kind of a big load to be swallowed at once. Now, it doesn't obviously matter if you're really, really enjoying the album, but for the rest of us, maybe a little bit too much. Like if you have this really good pizza and you're enjoying it, but then you realize that you're not gonna be able to eat it, but you'd still do it because, hey, you paid for it and you don't want to take it away with you. And then you're later on figure out it was kind of a mistake. You have your tummy hurts and you're like, man, I feel bad about it morally, and also because you're just too, I don't know, too stuck with the whole pizza deal. And that's the problem with this album. I mean, it's nicely executed otherwise, but there's just too much material, which I think is part of, you know, having repeating the patterns here with the songs, but also, in general, maybe a little bit of fat trimming wouldn't have hurt this particular baby. Now, all in all, this is a rather interesting case. I mean, it comes from Russia, and all these stories here are more or less about Norse mythology. It's an interesting case to just, you know, blend it together. But then again, Russia, or what was known as previous Russia anyway, had a lot of things to do with Vikings, so maybe it's not that far-fetched in terms of history and all. Now, lyrics and all these topics might be whatever it is, but we're here to talk about mostly about the music. People can get deeper into the lyrics in case they just love the music. And the music is mostly melodic black metal, like I said, very, very well produced, like a big orchestra kind of a thing. It's also somewhat progressive in songwriting. That is, these guys are not just doing your basic black metal riffs, be kind of a simple, kind of a fast bass, but they have everything. Some parts are faster, some parts are slower, and the point here is this is much like progressive black metal, equivalent to what are usually seen as, progressive death metal or, well, any kind of metal really. So whereas some bands stick to the basics, kind of rock and roll formula, having a rather short songs, radio fitting if you will, and kind of a simple riffs, creating the stuff that people are really easy to enjoy, kind of a catchy stuff, melodies and otherwise, this is going to a different direction. I'm not saying it's super technical or anything like that, but in the terms of progressive metal, this is like what happens when you give it a black metal handshake. And I find it rather interesting. Now, I'm mostly enjoying this album, but like I said, there is just too much of this fat which was not trimmed off. And I think it makes this album too heavy to listen at one go, especially multiple times, which I think is partially because, these songs are not that good. I mean, they really don't justify the existence of 66 minutes straight. I wouldn't, mind if this was, I don't know, some Dark Throne Golden Era quality or the like, but it's not. So while these songs are somewhat enjoyable and they're nicely executed, too much is too much. And that alone tells you a little bit. If you get the feeling, maybe you're not enjoying it as much as you could. But I really can't say that it's because of the production. It's mostly about songwriting. Now, vocals are, on the other hand, one of the weaker parts here. While they're totally doable in the sense of, giving this is black metal, they're kind of a dry and passionless, they really are not on the same level as the guys, handling their instruments and creating songs and, being progressive. The raspy vocals are just very basic stuff in the genre. Nothing really wow, nothing really bad. Overall, I would say this is pretty decent album. It's very, very much a worth listening to, but it's not really nailing it that hard. So is it so-called worthy a cigar, that is? I don't think so. It's a decent, it's quite enjoyable, it's quite good, but it's not a cigar time album. If you don't get the reference, don't worry about it. I'll explain you later. Anyway, give it a go, and I hope you'll enjoy it. Take care, and see you soon with more reviews coming your way.